These are some of the key concepts, and I want to start with them. One, put no block between the newcomer and step 12. Get the newcomer to step 12 as quickly as possible so he or she can recover and not stay in the pain and suffering of addiction or untreated recovery one moment longer than absolutely necessary.
Amen.
A good friend of mine, Chris R., talks about this in terms of the window of opportunity. How wide is that window? Is it a year? Absolutely not. Is it a month? Maybe, maybe not. Is it a week? Even that's pretty dicey. What if we only have today to take that person through the steps? And we knew how to do it in 2 to 3 hours. Why wouldn't we take that time to save that person's life? And that's what I do. And I'll be doing that again Thursday night. I did it Monday night in Niagara Falls, Ontario, and Thursday night I'll be doing it right here in Toronto, taking everybody in the room through all 12 steps in less than 90 minutes. It can be done. I've done it tens of thousands of times. And it works. It worked for Dr. Bob. If you take the history of Alcoholics Anonymous and read the significance of Dr. Bob's work, it's in writing in two of the source history books. AA Comes of Age, Pass It On, and in Dr. Bob and the Good Old Timers, where Dr. Bob took 5,000 people through the steps in 10 years. Do the math. It comes out to 1.3 people a day. And 3 out of 4 of them never drank again. So obviously, he knew how to do it. And that's what his sponsees passed on to me, and that's what I'm continuing to pass on as I travel around the world. So this is the key concept. Get the newcomer to step 12 as quickly as possible so he or she can experience the life-changing spiritual awakening that occurs as the direct result of taking all 12 steps. In the early days, the sponsor called the newcomer. The three things we know about a newcomer in the 1940s, number one, he or she did not have a book. Whoa. Two, did not have a telephone. And three, did not have a car. There were some exceptions to that, but this is in generalities. Let's talk about the book first. I'm going to tie 2 and 3 together. We're talking about number 3 was read the appropriate parts of the big book to the newcomer. Why? Because in the early days, this book cost the equivalent of $95 today, U.S. $95 U.S. Most groups in the 1940s had to pass the basket for weeks and months to get one book. And it was an honor to be chosen to read the appropriate parts of that book to the newcomer. But also what they found is that basically 90% of the book wasn't used to take newcomers through the work. I mean, I can go page after page after page and not find anything that was actually used by Dr. Bob and the pioneers to take people through the steps. So why would we hand a book to a newcomer and tell them to read it? Well, that isn't what they did in the early days. Let's sit down together and I'll read the appropriate parts of the big book to you. And again, that's what I'll be doing Thursday night. Reading the appropriate parts and taking you through all 12 steps. Call the newcomer. I don't know how that got turned around, you hand the newcomer a big book and then you also hand him a business card and say, call me. No, in the early days, it was a sponsor that called the newcomer. Why? Because the newcomer's sick. And we're supposed to have the answer. So why would we tell the newcomer to call us when it's so easy for us to call him or her? But in the early days, in terms of calling, it meant physically go to where the newcomer was, whether that be the jitter joint, the sanitarium, which is the equivalent of the psych wards today. Wherever the newcomer was, that's where the sponsor went. Other concepts from the 1940s, the healing is in the sharing, not in the writing. In the 1940s, most four-step inventories were done on the back of a business card, was done on a post-it note about this size, hotel stationery, back of envelopes, and the sponsor did the writing. The newcomer did the talking, the sponsor did the writing. Why? The newcomer's sick. How can you expect a newcomer to write? I shared this Monday night, and I'm going to share it again tonight. I had my life changed last Saturday. In Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, I'm taking a guy through the steps who came in late, was not matched up with a sharing partner, because in the Back to Basic seminars, everybody goes through the steps together. Nobody goes through the steps alone. Everybody is a sharing partner. He came in late. I took him as my sharing partner. When we did the two-hour lunch break, he announced to me right up front, he said, "I can't read or write." I said, "That's fine, because I'm going to read the big book passages to you. I'm going to write the four-step inventory, and I'm going to teach you about figure-step guidance in step 11. And he lit up like a Christmas tree, took him through the work. When we got to step 11, he shared with me something. I lit up like a Christmas tree. I'd never heard anything like this before. And we both had our lives changed. We find a lot of people today can't read or write, at least in the United States. I mean, they're dumbing down the educational system. I mean, there are many, many people coming in off the streets that cannot read or write. So why would we deny them the chance to recover? When this is the way it was done in the 1940s, the sponsor does the writing. Assist the newcomer with his or her amends. Be the first person that the newcomer sees after amends is made. Share guidance with the newcomer. This again is another concept from the 1940s. 11-step guidance books. And we found hundreds of these in the various archival collections throughout the United States and Canada. And again, the archival collections in Canada that I went through were Toronto, Montreal, and Vancouver, British Columbia. And basically the quote-unquote official guidance book from the 1940s was a pocket-sized notebook with a spiral wound at the top. Spiral wound pocket notebook. And you record your guidance. That's what your morning meditation is all about. Record what God has asked you to do for the day. And I do this kind of facetiously, but I'll go ahead and do it today. In terms of the 11th step, if I haven't written anything down, it's really easy to do the nightly review. Look at this. I did everything God asked me to do today. Nightly review. Done. But if you've actually written something down, you do have something to review. Maybe I haven't done what I was asked to do today. Maybe I do need to redouble my efforts in some area. So share guidance with the newcomer. Demonstrate to the newcomer that, yes, I am practicing step 11, and this is what I received in guidance today. And teach the newcomer how to sponsor by co-sponsoring the next newcomer. You sponsor the next newcomer together, so the newcomer learns how to sponsor directly from you. So that's how the beginner's means got started in the 1940s.